हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू आर क्वाइट रिलैक्स्ड आफ्टर एंड फ्रेश टू आफ्टर वन मंथ समर ब्रेक. दोज हू आर वेरी रेगुलर इन डूइंग देयर क्लास वर्क मस्ट बी सो, बट दोज हू केप्ट पेंडिंग देयर वर्क माइट नॉट बी रिलैक्स्ड इवन आफ्टर 30 डेज ऑफ अ ब्रेक. So these are just my guesses. Hopefully all of you must have enjoyed your holidays. Some of you might have had exciting and interesting days. For a few it might be quite relaxing. As for we teachers, these 30 days were full of relaxation because we were not bound to prepare these videos and all. So whatever the case may be, now we have to resume the session and carry on with our curriculum in the same way, as there is no chance of getting the schools reopened. So before I start with the new topic, children, I would just like to make you recall. Just a few seconds back I spoke about holidays. How were your holidays and how was mine? While speaking on that, I used a few words: relaxing, exciting, boring, interesting. All these words I used to describe the holidays, the duration, the vacation. So from here I'll come to the topic of the day. These words I had used to describe holidays, and our topic of the day is similar to this: describing words. Describing words are also termed as adjectives. Adjectives are called as describing words. So that was a way to start my topic and come to the topic which I have to take up. So welcome back once again, and let's begin with our session. The topic of the day is adjectives. Adjectives, as I just told you a few seconds back, they are also known as describing words. In other words, they add something to a noun. When I was talking about holidays, that was a noun, and the words I spoke for that, describing those holidays, was adding something to that noun, holidays, and that is how those words became adjectives. So they add something to a noun to describe its quantity, quality, number and possession. Say if we talk about holidays and we talk about its quantity, we will not say quantity, we will say about number of holidays you had. You had 30 days holidays or 1 month holidays. And quality, as I said, some might say interesting, some might say boring, some might say very busy holidays, some might say very relaxing holidays. That comes in quality. And possession, if you say that were your holidays, you can say. But there's a way that is a this possession is a somewhat a concept to be understood really well. So to start, initially you have to remember what is an adjective. Adjectives are the words that describe a noun or that add something to the noun we are talking about. In today's session we will be covering only kinds of adjectives. Here is a summary of what is on the next page. I'll be teaching you from that page, but you need to read this as well. This is just a kind of, you can say, brushing up your knowledge of what you had been doing for, what you had done rather, for class 4 and class 5. Then we will be taking up later on the formation of adjectives. How do we usually make a word an adjective? Next will come the position of adjective. Sometimes 2-3 adjectives are there in a sentence, and which is the right order of placing them, that we will be taking up. And then we will be doing comparisons of adjectives. Comparison of adjectives, children, is nothing but the degrees of adjectives which you have done in your lower grades. So we'll take up the topic in detail now, kinds of adjectives. You will not open your books, children. You will take up the session as it is, and only after the session is over, then you will open your module and do it this very day. Do not keep the work pending. Open your book and mark that time in the second go. You will mark the important things whichever you feel are necessary to be marked. So here is a definition of adjectives, and this adjective, which I've already explained, this adjective may consist of more words than one. It could be one word adjective, as in the case of this beautiful girl, each question, clever Indian, clever each, beautiful big, here for the tree. These all are adjectives which are only one word. But there are times when we have a group of words as an adjective, as a describing word. In that case, we call it adjectival phrase or adjectival. So here we have question A also related to this. So when you come across something describing in one word, a word describing a noun in one word, that will be a simple adjective. And a group of words describing an adjective, a noun, will be considered as adjectival phrase. For example, if I say a pair of big eyes. Pair of big eyes and carrot and stick policy. Here a pair of big is for eyes, so it's a group of words, a pair of big. And here carrot and stick is, again, we are talking about policy. It's a kind of phrase, and that is how group of words that makes sense but incomplete sense, gives you half the meaning. They hold some meaning, but they make a complete meaning when they are used with certain other words. That is known as a phrase, as for the case carrot and stick. So this refers to a strict policy, you can say. When an adjectival phrase is used before a noun, the words are joined with hyphens. Usually you will find these words, a group of words with a pair of words there and having hyphen in between, 10 story, 2-year-old. So it's quite the way of writing this language is also changing. Somewhere you may find these hyphens and somewhere you may not. Whatever the case may be, this is an adjectival phrase. Coming to the kinds of adjective, the first one is adjective of quality or descriptive adjective. You can choose either of the two to name the kind. And the thing is that you must not go wrong with the spelling. So whether you call it descriptive adjective or you call it adjective of quality, it is one and the same thing. As the word itself makes it clear, the phrase itself makes it clear that anything that describes the quality of a noun, and this quality could be color, shape, size, texture, condition, material, quality and national and even origin, whether the thing is American, Indian, Philippines, something like that, or Chinese, you can say, very common these days, this word Chinese goods are to be boycotted. So these come in the category of these words, or such adjectives will be called adjectives of quality. Next comes adjective of quantity. They are also known as quantifiers. So quantity, as the word is itself very clear, it will tell you about the amount of things or persons. You can name things or persons are also called nouns. And if you get confused ever that whether it is quantity or whether it is quality, you simply ask your question. First look for the word which is an adjective, and then ask yourself a question. Is it answering how much or how many? Look, for example, enough hard work, and my question will be how much hard work. If I say little confidence, my question will be how much confidence. So you have to identify the noun to put this question, how much question or how many question, which will be in the next time. So your knowledge of nouns and the adjective itself should be very thorough if you want to locate the correct adjective with the correct kind as well. So usually the quantity adjective or quantifier as an adjective will answer the question how much. If I say whole of the class, it will be how much our means will be part, what part of the class will be participating, and the answer will be whole of the class. Next comes adjectives of number. Number, as it denotes here, very clear again that it will answer how many. Quantity is how much always, and this is adjective number is how many. These adjective indicates how many persons or things, or the order of person or things. Actually, there are three further subtypes of this adjective, adjective of number. But suppose you get a question on this, pick out the adjective and name its kind, and you are not able to give this subheadings there, no need to worry. Even if you put there adjective of number, it will be okay. No, it will not be wrong. Howsoever, we need to learn how many subtypes of this adjective of number are. So here we go. I'll take up this again. Adjective of number tells you or indicate how many persons or things, or the order of the persons or things. Order means first, second or third. Actually, numbers are of two types if you remember your mathematics, ordinal and cardinals. You must have done in your lower grades these two. So that is how there are three further subtypes of adjective of number: definite numeral adjective, indefinite numeral adjective, and the third one we'll take up later on. So definite numeral adjective tells you the exact number. Look at the example, one boy, two, it's very specific, that is why the word comes definite. And it is of two types, ordinal as well as cardinal. Cardinal will give you the number of the adjective, of the noun, and ordinal will give you the order or the position of the noun. Look at the examples here, one boy, two boy, three birds. It is giving you the exact number, and that is how these are called cardinals. These are cardinals, and with one we can locate first, with the two we can relate second, and with three we can relate third. So both these kinds come in the category of definite adjectives. This note you leave will be, there's no need to do this part, but you can read it. The ordinals also function as demonstrative adjectives. We also call them demonstrative adjectives at times. Next comes indefinite numeral adjectives. Now they do not indicate any specific number. They do not indicate any specific number. You're talking about a noun, but you are not specifying the exact number of that noun. Say, for example, no boys, you're talking about boys, but you mean none. Few girls, you're talking about a good number of girls, maybe 4, 5, 6, but you're not specifying the exact number, and that is how the type comes, indefinite numeral adjective. Next is distributive numeral adjective. Now, distributive, as the word denotes, means you are not talking about any specific person, any specific noun, but you are allocating the thing to all but none. There are some few selective words which come in this category or type: each, every, either, neither. They denote each person or thing referred to. You're talking about a group, but you are specifying each and everyone in that group, or in that group of nouns individually. And that is how the easiest way to remember this is to just Actually, this part which I told you to leave for the ignore or just leave it. It is important, but first let's focus on this part that you easily understand the subtypes. Later on, I will tell you how this can also function as demonstrative adjectives if it is needed. So let's move on with the topic further. some, this is important children, some adjectives may be used both as adjectives of number and adjectives of quantity. These might be the common words, but these can be used along with the countable nouns as well. A basic and a minute, you can say, or a hint, no, I will not say minute, but a basic way, or the most easy way to identify is that if you're talking about an uncountable thing, uncountable grain is uncountable, you weigh them, money is though we count $10,000, but money is considered as uncountable noun. Salt, water, all these are measured in quantities. They are amount. Money is an amount, you say. Amount is also called quantity. So that is how. But here, if you check for adjective of number, you will find all countable nouns there. Photographs, plates, men, boys. And that is how these same words could be used for both as adjectives, as of quantity, an adjective of number. Just read it, it will be very clear to you what I have said. All you have to remember is that we can have common adjectives for quantity also and for number also, the same words for quantity, the same word for number. How will you make out that whether it is adjective of quantity or number? You will find for number you will find a countable thing here, and for quantity you will find an uncountable noun here. Always remember, adjectives are related to nouns. They are in relation to nouns. They add something to nouns. Next comes demonstrative adjectives, or we also call them demonstratives. Now these are usually the words which point to the exact noun we wish to refer to. For example, if I come back to this note which I told you to leave, again I won't be able to show you this. I'll just lift my page. This is this box. It's not very clear. But you just skip that box which I told you, note, the first note on this page. Then if I say first boy, I am specifying the boy, which boy I'm talking about, first boy, the 10th student sitting in the row, I am specifying which student, and that is how it can be a first, second, or you can say the definite numerals can also be called demonstratives. But if you name either of them, if you are asked for the kind and there is first student or second boy in the row, something like that, if you call it demonstrative adjective, then also it will be right. And if you call it adjective of number, then also it will be right. And if you say it is a definite numeral adjective, that is also correct. All the three types which you will mention, all three will be correct. So here we go. Are the words which points to the exact noun we wish to refer to, means they will point out to the exact or the particular noun you are talking about. For example, if I say this book, I mean that particular book only, and these books, this is singular and these is plural, that is singular and those is plural. The difference is the I'll explain here. This is used for near, this and these is used for near objects, and that and those is referred, is used to refer the things or the nouns at a distance. So, and this is the singular of these, and that is the singular of those. So you have to keep in mind two things: the distance, whether the thing is near or at near or far or at a distance, or the thing is singular or plural. That is how you will be able to use the correct words among these. Again, I would come back to definite numeral adjective, that note part which says that these ordinals are also function as demonstrative adjectives. When I say, I repeat this, when I say the second girl or those two girls, I am specifying which two girls I'm talking about, and that is how these are, sorry, not the cardinals but the ordinals only, first girl or second girl, in that case the ordinal also functions as a demonstrative adjective. You may mention here first girl, it's not cardinal, it is only for ordinals, first girl, or it could be third boy, the third boy, the first. So these are the words which specify to the exact boy or the girl I'm talking about, and that is how they become demonstrative adjectives. Interrogatives are question words, And these questions, what you have to keep in mind, you may wonder, if I ask how are you, how is also a question word, and that is how it becomes a interrogative adjective. No, children, what you have to keep in mind that these words are used to ask questions with reference to a particular noun. Again, as I said before, there's a connectivity between the adjectives and a noun. Adjectives are the words which add to the information or which add something to the noun. For example, it will be clearer when you read the example. Which film? So which will become an interrogative adjective because film is my noun, and my which holds is asking a question related to the noun film. Again, whose idea? Idea is a noun, and whose is the word which is inquiring about the idea. And what noise? Noise is again an abstract noun, and this is what this word what is inquiring about noise. So it's necessary, it's must to have a noun just after the interrogative word, then only it will become an interrogative adjective. Usually you will find these adjectives, interrogative adjectives, especially demonstrative adjectives, again especially you will have a noun just after these words which are considered as demonstratives, which are considered as interrogatives. Next comes possessive adjectives. Now this one is a bit tricky one. You need to focus well on this. Possessive, as the word shows, means belongingness. So when an adjective shows that a certain thing or person belongs to somebody or something, again I would like to add there, you have to see it in connection with a noun. That a certain thing or person, that means a noun, belongs to somebody or something, then it is called a possessive adjective. For example, my mother. Now mother, whose mother it is? My mother. I have my here, mother here. Mother is a noun, and what whose mother is the lady? My. So my becomes possessive adjective. Again, a point to be kept in mind is here, you will always have a noun after it. See these examples: my duty, our duty, your duty, his duty, its duty. Whatever the words are there, there is a noun after it, and that is duty. As I said, my mother, their house, house, mother, his father, father again. These are the words, father, mother, these are the nouns, and the word just used before it shows that whom the thing belongs to, and that is how the type comes possessive adjectives. However, there's a note here which you have to keep in mind. Do not use any apostrophe S with these possessive adjectives. You cannot use my apostrophe S, your apostrophe S. That is how when you write a letter, an informal letter to your friend or parent or any aunt, uncle, that time you we discourage you to write yours loving. It is always your loving friend, or it is simply yours without an apostrophe. So that is what you have to remember here. The only expression in the pronoun one which takes an apostrophe S to form its possessive adjective, the only exception is the pronoun one. One, if it is used here as an adjective, will be taking apostrophe S. One's duty. If I use here one's duty, then it will be only apostrophe, and it will be the only word which will take apostrophe S. I hope it is clear. If not, just rewind the part from where you lost your means the rapport was lost, and the connectivity between my speaking part and your understanding was not there. So and just watch and listen to the video again. In case there is any doubt, you may put up your doubts in the Google Classroom, and I'll answer them. You will take up the session once again before the day is over. Mark the important points and just tally with what I am speaking and with what has been marked here. Your homework is to do the adjacent page and also do question part C there on page 228. See, I'll be not helping now the initial months, 2 months I've been helping you by solving some parts. But now you will be doing the same yourself. Try your hand first and use only pencil to do. Here I have mentioned the part there. I will also give you as a homework there. If you missed it, actually the space cannot be managed with the size of the screen here. So do see part C on page 228. This page, that is 219, as well as page, I'll write here page 219 full, and page 228 you will be doing only part C. Try your hand at least for question C. I would like to say that you might have different answers. If somebody likes a red color balloon, means here it is very obvious because an is used, so you have to use a vowel sound here. Otherwise, for size, for quality, for nationality, again you have an article which will specify that you cannot use any other word except a vowel sounding word, or you can say a word with a vowel sound. Age, it could be anything here. So this part the answers may vary, but for the rest of the day you have specific answers only. So do it, children. Try your hand on this, and it will naturally give you confidence that yes, you are able to do things on your own. Now it's high time that you start taking up the things on your own. That will help to boost up your confidence level. And in case of any doubt, you may upload your queries. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.